Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal. A wonderful chat with your friend Tally. She's not what I expected from her psych report. I like her.
Tally's a good friend. We've been through a lot together.
Quarians are so fascinating to me, but they also make me a little sad.
Why do they make you sad?
Their environment suits are so beautiful, but with their immune systems, they're trapped inside. I wonder what they look like under those helmets, or what their skin feels like under those suits.
Are you attracted to other species?
Well, part of my job is predicting the motives and feelings of humans and aliens. Intimacy brings understanding. And passion is nice wherever you find it. Character matters, not race or gender. Anything else, Commander?
That'll be all.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Did you hear that we are sharing our deck with a Krogan?
Well, ain't that peachy?
Shepard, what can I do for you?
Can you do anything to give the Normandy an edge over a collector ship?
Definitely. With the right supplies, I can fortify our shields. The collectors cut through the Normandy's barriers immediately last time. My upgrades might give us a better chance. Shepard, what can I do for you?
Is the new Normandy giving you any trouble?
Please, Shepard, I'm a Quarian. Give me a chunk of scrap metal, a circuit board, and some Element Zero, and I'll have it making precision jumps. I was worried about working with Cerberus engineers, but they know what they're doing, and they've been very polite.
How's the Normandy running?
Say what you will about Cerberus. They know how to build ships. The Normandy's running even better than before. I don't know if it can stand up to a collector attack, though. I'm researching some ideas that might help.
Can you do anything to give the Normandy an edge over a collector ship?
My shield fortification will help, but I don't think there is much more I can do.
Have you got time to talk?
We didn't really have time to chat while taking out Geth on Haystrom, did we? I can't believe so many people died. Thank you again for getting Rieger out alive. All for data about stars blowing up. I hope the Admiralty Board gets some use out of it.
Have you heard any word about Cal Rieger? Did he survive his injuries?
He sent me a message. It looks like he'll make a full recovery. Anytime you get a suit puncture, it's a matter of luck. Rieger got out with a relatively minor infection.
Tell me about the fleet's Admiralty Board.
It's one of two major political powers among my people. The admirals make decisions related to defense or needing immediate action. They also handle major criminal charges, like treason. The other political power is the Conclave, a group of representatives from each ship. They make most of our laws and fleet decisions.
Any news yet on the data you sent?
I'm not likely to hear anything for a while, or on an unsecured channel, for that matter.
Having any trouble settling back in on the Normandy?
I like the quiet. I miss the old faces, though. Presley, Engineer Adams, all of them. It doesn't seem right having Cerberus in charge of this ship. Are you sure working for them is the right thing to do?
I caught some tension back on Freedom's Progress and again when you first came aboard. What happened between Cerberus and the Quarians?
They attacked one of our ships, the Idena. It seems they were attempting to kill or control a young human biotic who was on the fleet. I don't really know the details. I do know that Cerberus made an enemy of the Quarian people.
Does it look like they're pulling the strings, Tally? I'm not working for them. They're working for me.
So you ordered the listening devices and tracking beacons that are all over this ship. I know you need resources to fight the Collectors, but be careful, Shepard.
I don't like working with them any more than you do, but we need them.
I know. Just watch yourself. You're their best weapon right now. But as soon as you no longer serve their needs, be ready for them to turn on you. For now, I should get back to work. Thanks for coming by.
What can we do for you, Commander?
Carry on.
Will do, Commander.
Welcome to Nos Astra, Commander Shepard. We've been instructed to waive all docking and administration fees for your visit. My name is Karina. If you need information about the area, it would be my pleasure to assist you.
Who instructed you to waive the fees?
The order came from Liara Tassoni, who paid all fees on your behalf. She also asked that I direct you to speak with her at your convenience. She's near the trading floor.
What can you tell me about Nos Astra?
It's an exciting city. We see a lot of new cultures and goods because of our proximity to the Terminus systems. At the same time, Illium is still in a sorry world. You should be as safe here as you would be on the Citadel. For your own safety, however, I recommend against signing anything.
What's so dangerous about signing something?
Illium is a free trade world, Commander. Contract term requirements are more relaxed here than on other planets. It's a small price to pay for keeping our competitive edge in goods from the Terminus systems.
You mentioned trading. What gets traded on Illium?
Anything you can imagine, Commander. Illium is a wonderful world for those who can afford it. In order to remain competitive as a Terminus systems port, we've relaxed many of the standards you'd find on other Asari worlds. Most drugs are legal, provided they are labeled properly. You can buy almost any weapon or technology. You can even buy indentured servants.
I can't believe an Asari world would allow slavery.
We try to avoid calling it slavery. All indentured servants on Illium have voluntarily agreed to a term of service. Most choose indentured service as a means to pay off debt or avoid imprisonment. A contract holder is responsible for the well-being of her servants, and a servant's duties are agreed upon before the contract is...
Do you have any recommendations about what to do on Nos Astra?
Our trading center is directly ahead. You'll find restaurants and shops nearby as well. I suggest you browse our shopping kiosks. You can find things on Nos Astra that you can't find anywhere else in the galaxy.
I'm on a mission. Can you help me find someone?
I can help you find major entertainment centers or stores, but I'm afraid I can't point you to individual people. Liara is excellent at that type of work, however. I imagine she can help you.
You said Liara was here? What is she doing?
Liara is one of Nos Astra's most respected information brokers. Nos Astra is based upon trade. Information is valuable currency, and Liara has done quite well. As I said, you'll find her near the trading floor. She was looking forward to seeing you.
Thank you.
Again, welcome to our city, Commander. Please enjoy your stay.
Customs records indicated Justicar named Samara is visiting this port, Shepard. Your former teammate, Liara Tassoni, may have more information. Her office overlooks the trading floor. You may wish to speak with her regarding the whereabouts of Thane Krios, the assassin on your dossier, as well.
A Batarian trading group has announced plans to sue the Citadel Council. The Batarians claim that slavery is an inextricable part of their caste system, and that by limiting the slave trade, the Council is violating their cultural rights. The indentured servitude market closed down 3 points, with representatives decrying the unwanted controversy.
25. Sell at 25.
No. You're not hearing me. I want to buy it up. Buy it all up.
Come on, give me something.
You're Commander Shepard? I saw your... I guess you would say your aura. I'd recognize you anywhere. I was asked to give you a message if I saw you. It's from a friend you made on Novaria.
I met a lot of people on Novaria. Could you be more specific?
I believe the message itself should make it clear. Shepard, we hide, we borrow, we build, but we know that you seek those who soured the songs of our mothers. When the time comes, our voice will join with yours, and our crescendo will burn the darkness clean. Thank you, Shepard. The Rachni will sing again because of you.
I'm glad to hear that you're rebuilding. Are you somewhere close by?
The Rachni Queen is not here. That message is one of many memories I carry from her. I encountered her on an uncharted world. She saved my life. More than that, she gave me a purpose. They are an amazing people, Shepard. The galaxy owes you a great debt for giving them a second chance.
How did you find the Rachni?
I was working as a courier. Pirates ambushed my ship, and I was forced down on an uncharted planet. I was badly injured, alone and near death. Then they found me. They saved me.
You obviously got off-world again. Did the Rachna give you a ship?
No. Countless workers repaired my ship. It runs better now than it did before. They remind me of the Keepers on the Citadel in a way. All working together, each with a purpose.
What happened to the pirates who attacked you?
They were obliterated, as they should have been. The Rachna are not aggressive, but they do what they must.
You said the Queen gave you a purpose. What do you mean?
The Queen shared her song with me as I recovered. I saw the Rachna as only an Asari could. They are so beautiful and so vulnerable. They needed someone to purchase things they cannot make themselves. Someone to work within the system. An agent, if you will. I am happy to help. My life as a courier was empty and shallow. Now I'm helping a great race rebuild itself.
You were really comfortable walking away from your old life?
You're concerned that the Queen is controlling me. I understand, but it doesn't work like that. Our minds were in perfect harmony. I saw their beautiful spirit and their need. I knew what I had to do. If some part of that is suggestion, then it was a side effect from their efforts to save my life. I am happy.
Can you tell me where the Rachna are?
I'm afraid not. I don't even have that information myself any longer. After I met the Rachna Queen, that information was removed. It's not painful, but I simply don't remember. I'll remember when I need to, and her caution is understandable. The galaxy isn't yet ready for the return of the Rachna.
I got that she was grateful. What else was her message saying?
That the first Rachna war was a mistake. Something soured the voices of her people. In Rachna psychology, that would be like mind control, I think. It doesn't really translate. Anyway, she believes you are fighting the ones who did that, and she promises to help.
She thinks that the Reapers caused the Rachna War?
I can't say for sure, but she was certain that her ancestors were forced into war against their will. Her people aren't naturally aggressive. If they made war, it was not of their own doing.
Thank you for giving me that information. I'm glad my friend on Novaria is doing well.
Be well, Commander Shepard. You will not see me again.
Shepard? The news said you were dead. What happened?
No, wait, probably classified. Forget I asked. You just have to lie. It's been a couple of years. I'm Gianna Parasini, Novaria Internal Affairs. You helped me nail Administrator Analeas.
Happy to help. What happened to Administrator Analeas?
He made the one mistake Novaria won't tolerate. He got caught taking their money. He's doing a few years in white-collar prison. More importantly, he won't work in the field again. Sit down. If I remember right, I owe you a beer. What brings you to Illium? You know, that you can talk about.
You ever heard of the Collectors? They're attacking human colonies. I'm gonna stop them.
Damn, Shepard. For me, a tough job involves more paperwork. Hey, listen, I just remembered something. I've gotta go. Talk to you later. And don't forget to drink your beer.
Welcome. You look like someone who needs high-quality equipment. Feel free to look around. My store has the best tech and biotic equipment on Illium.
Is everything here so expensive? I'd planned to drop a lot of credits today.
Really?
I'm outfitting a team for a dangerous mission. I need the best, and I'm willing to pay for it, as long as you work with me.
Well, perhaps I could give you a preferred rate at the kiosk. Here, a small discount, and when I get special items in, you can take a look.
What kind of special items are we talking about?
Oh, you know, schematics, designs. Nothing illegal, but I may not have all the licenses to sell them.
Do you have anything else? Anything not listed on your main merchandise kiosk?
Well, there is one thing. Very advanced design. Not publicly available yet.
That's because it's still in development on Novaria, and illegal for export. Hello, Hermia.
Parasini! You set me up! But this isn't Novaria! You don't have the authority to arrest me!
I don't care whether you go to jail. I've got all the evidence I need to find you out of business.
Do you have the authority to seize the schematics she's trying to sell?
I don't have to. Hermia was under suspicion. We leaked a faulty device to her. All this thing will ever do is blow up in your face.
I need to go. I have to talk to my lawyer.
Talk fast, Hermia. When the fines hit, you won't be able to afford him. Ah, that was good. I've got to go file a few papers. Come by my table when you've got a minute.
This should come in handy.
Hermia is going to be a very poor woman very shortly. Thanks for the help, Shepard. I love nailing Asari. So ageless and superior. Then you get them and they squeal like schoolgirls.
How long were you after this woman?
A few weeks, plus transit time. Not nearly as long as Analeas. Well, at least this time I didn't have to wear heels and a dress.
How'd you end up on Novaria anyway?
Scholarship program, and a competitive internship. Turned out I was only middling at the science, but I could always ferret out secrets. You grow up poor and surrounded by rich kids, you get good at hiding yourself. Helps with going undercover.
What's up next for you?
Research. We've had some hacking attacks lately, and I want to make sure they're external. A lot of people are suddenly interested in dark energy. My bosses want to know if it's something to worry about. That'll hold me over until I have to go back undercover anyway.
Must be hard going undercover so often.
It's not so bad. Go new places, be new people. The only weird part is when you go home and try to talk to people, and you forget how to react. Like it's another cover, you know?
Deep down, part of you likes fooling people. That's what makes you good at it.
Part of me? Yeah. I grew up poor and working class. Now I walk around the rich and powerful, taking notes, getting evidence. And they never see me coming.
It's been a pleasure, Gianna.
You too, Shepard. See you around.
Flashier. I want something that says, I own this world.
Are you a Quarian or Volus who is tired of being passed over for promotions because of discrimination against
everyone? I'm gonna have that asshole arrested. Watch yourself if you go in there. Some human is causing trouble. He's demanding that I sign the place over to him.
Is there anything I can do?
Oh no. That crap might fly on Omega, but this is Illium. I'm hooking up security cams now. If he or anybody else causes trouble, I'll have their asses arrested.
I still don't see why we're here. Salarians do not get married. My family simply negotiated a reproduction contract.
Whatever. It's the closest you guys get to a wedding. And that means you get a bachelor party. End of story.
I don't understand. Humans celebrate wedding contracts by tempting infidelity? That makes no sense.
Calm down, man. Don't embarrass me in front of the stripper.
What do Turians do? Do Turians do this too?
I'm just here for the drinks.
You said that bachelor parties are for very close friends. We're just co-workers.
We've been co-workers for 5 years, though. Aren't Solarian years like dog years?
Okay, now that's offensive. I appreciate the gesture, but my people don't even have sex drives the way humans do.
Uh-huh. Take a look at that, man. Everybody likes the Asari. Everybody.
But we actually reproduce by... My word. She is very... I can appreciate her dancing in an aesthetic manner, but I don't have feelings of... She is lovely, she
Okay, that makes my legs hurt just watching it, and my knees are meant to bend that way.
This isn't as bad as I fear. It's actually... Is it warm in here?
Okay, you see that bit there?
A little divot in her abdomen?
It's called a belly button. Humans and Asari have them. You're gonna be doing shots out of it later tonight.
That can't be sanitary.
Not the point, man.
I can understand why I might find Asari attractive, but how can they be attractive to humans, too? They look just like Solarians.
What? They look exactly like us. I'm not seeing the Solarian thing at all. At all.
You're both wrong. Asari look just like Bluturians. Look at the head fringe.
Wait, you don't think they're, like, mind-controlling us to see them as attractive, do you?
Please be quiet. You're going to ruin Asari for me. There aren't many Turian women on Illium.
Well, I suppose watching just one more dance wouldn't hurt.
That's the spirit.
As long as I'm not paying for the drinks.
I still don't see why we're here. Solarians do not get married. My family simply negotiated a reproduction contract.
Whatever. It's the closest you guys get to a wedding.
So then he says, oh, it's okay. Our amino acids are all...
You're really holding out on me? I'm a man on the edge. I got nothing to lose.
Uh-huh.
I'll do anything to get the job done. I'll go all the way without a second thought.
Uh-huh.
You want to see how far I'll go? I learned how to shove a gun in people's faces from... Commander Shepard?
Hey. If you know this idiot, can you rein him in before I slap his ass with a singularity?
Shepard? Is it really you? It's me, Conrad Werner! We met on the Citadel? I wanted to become a Spectre? Oh, and then you shoved a gun in my face? You showed me what it meant to be truly extreme. I learned that lesson well. So you're alive, huh? I hear it goes like that in the biz. Why don't you sit back and watch how it's done? I got some asses to kick.
Conrad, why are you acting like me?
What, are you crazy? I'm nothing like you. I'm not a specter working for the Council. I'm on my own, backed only by my wits and my nerves. No rules, no laws, just whatever it takes to get the job done. I'm not like you at all.
Conrad, do you have any actual combat training?
I'm saving the galaxy, Shepard. I don't have time for training. Don't you get it? You were a big jerk. But you saved the galaxy and showed other races that humans mattered. And then you died. The galaxy needed someone like you, Shepard. We all did. I had to do something.
How'd you get that armor?
Oh, they make some pretty convincing replicas these days, if you're willing to pay. Getting the whole getup was pretty expensive, but my wife was really supportive. She even paid for my shuttle fare off-world.
So you just wander the galaxy righting wrongs?
Hey, don't say it like that. I talk to people, you know? Ask them if they have big problems that only I can solve. You'd be surprised how many people are just waiting for someone to talk to them. Sometimes I poke through crates, too. You know, for extra credits.
How'd you get that armor?
Getting the whole getup was pretty expensive, but my
Any
wife...
decent security system will detect that you aren't in the military, much less part of my squad.
I just say that I'm decover and don't appear on systems. I'm doing the best I can, okay? You were a hero. You saved the galaxy and showed everyone what humanity could do. And then you died. The galaxy needed someone like you, Shepard. We all did. I had to do something.
Why were you trying to get the deed to this place?
This place is actually a front for a red sand dealer. I need to take it over to crack the ring.
What? Who the hell told you that?
The owner of that weapons store near the carport? She's an undercover cop. She told me about it when I introduced myself.
Listen, crap for brains. First, we don't sell red sand. Second, red sand is legal on Illium. You just need a license.
I'll talk to this undercover cop and figure out what's going on.
Thank you. If I kill annoying customers, it usually causes property damage. That comes out of my pay.
Just let me know if you need any help, Shepard.
The Asari are how advanced? And this is what they do with it? Money is still power. Same old, same old. Doesn't seem like they're so far ahead, does it?
Thanks for taking care of that crazy guy. Saves me having to beat him to death with his own spine. That makes the other customers nervous. Anyway, this is Eternity, and I'm Athida, Asari matriarch and bartender. Get you anything?
You're an Asari matriarch? I thought matriarchs served as honored advisors.
Right. Which I do here at this bar. I know, not what you'd expect. But nobody on Thessia wanted to listen to my wise counsel, so here I am. Dad was a Krogan who fought in the Rachni Wars. My mother fought in the Krogan Rebellions. I've pretty much seen it all.
Your mother fought in the Krogan Rebellions?
I don't know whether she fought. She scouted, sniped a few people, and blew up a couple of space stations. You know, commando stuff. She'd put the old commando leathers on for special nights with Dad. Goddess, that was embarrassing.
If your mother fought in the Rebellions and your father was a Krogan, didn't that cause tension?
They didn't meet until a few hundred years after the Turians put the boot in with the damn Genophage. As far as either one knew, they were both just warriors. Dad boasted. Mom stayed quiet. Mom was a matriarch herself. Dad was near on 1,000 when the truth came out.
What happened when he found out?
I was about 100, shaking my ass in some sleazy bar. They got me on the link. Told me that they were gonna have it out. And made me promise to love whichever one survived. Turned out to be damn easy, since neither one did. Family, huh? What a kick in the quad.
You said your father fought in the Rachni Wars?
Yeah, when he was young. Love showing off his war scars. Krogan think they're sexy. Me, I go for asses. I was a girl, he'd tell me about landing on this poison-filled world and stomping Arachni Queen into muck. Scientists say all that stuff about us getting genetic material from a father is crap. Seems like I got a bit of his mouth, though.
Why is a matriarch in a bar serving drinks?
It's better than what most other matriarchs are doing. Look at that screw-up with Saren and his Geth a few years back. Their ships were hanging bare-assed in space when Saren started shooting. If not for you humans, we would have bought it right there. And I warned him. Told people on Thessia what was coming, and they didn't want to hear it.
What didn't they want to hear?
That art and philosophy and political prowess wasn't gonna cut it. We can't go a single Asari lifetime without some big war breaking out. We need to get our daughters working earlier, not spending their wild maiden years stripping or in merc bands. When I started talking about making new mass relays ourselves, they laughed the blew off my ass. So now, I serve drinks.
What's it like living for nearly 1,000 years?
Violent. Wars break out. Colonies get destroyed. Sometimes you hear good news, like that colony on Pharos surviving. That's the exception, though. You find peace in whatever arms will hold you. Turian, Elcor, Hanar. Even had a pureblood daughter. I was the father. Didn't work out. And one day you wake up, your figure's gotten matriarchal, and everyone else is too young to remember how the Quarians looked inside those suits.
Thanks for telling me about that.
That's what I'm here for, babe. Get you anything else?
I'd like something to drink.
Sure. I'll set up a tab at the drink kiosk. Knock yourself out. Literally, if you want. Just don't drink anything for Turians or Quarians. It does nasty things to your insides. Once saw Krogan drink a liquefied Turian on a dare 6 or 7 centuries back. Nobody came out of that one looking pretty.
What's it like being an Asari matriarch?
Pretty much like being anything else. My parents had it more interesting than I did.
Thanks for telling me about that.
All right. Don't even...
You deserve somebody who respects you. Somebody who's going to treat you right.
Oh, I think I'm just going to stop dating for a while.
No, don't do that. Don't let some human spoil you.
It's always the same thing.
Ooh, she could get sick. She's vulnerable. I wonder what she looks like under the helmet.
We'll find someone out there who cares about you for who you are. Someone whose food you can eat, even. If you're looking for things to do, maybe after work we could catch a hit or something.
Oh, that's sweet. But I'm okay. A little dry spell is gonna kill me.
Excuse me, I'm waiting for someone.
Good luck talking to the weapons merchant. Remember, she's at the shop by the car.
Living at a higher altitude make you more intelligent? Our report may surprise you. New data commissioned by the Architectural Union has noted a correlation between tests and intelligence.
If this is the best you have, I'll make do. But you're certain the neural stimulators are compatible with both minds and a solid physiology.
Are you shorting prefabs?
Why not? I did it after eating prime.
Listen, I know the data is vital to the Kurosa family. Nasana Dantius didn't give us time to pack. I'm lucky I got out at all. Her mercenaries were starting to shoot. If she lets us back in, I'll get it, I promise. If not, well, we'll just have to hope. Excuse me, I'm on an important call.
Sorry, I'm busy right now. I can't help you. If you need something, talk to admin.
Illium is the gateway to the Traverse. But is that gate open too wide? Investment think tanks are noting concerns that new technological discoveries...
Trust me, the goods coming in from the Terminus systems are great for business.
I don't know. Some of them seem dangerous.
That's the whole point. Danger means more contract work for us.
Can I help you with something?
I talked to an old friend, Conrad Werner. You told him that the Eternity Lounge was selling red sand.
Oh, you're Conrad's friend. Yes, that place is really dangerous. I should know. I'm an undercover cop. Did you get me the deed to the bar? I need the deed to, stop the red sand dealers.
I softened up the bar owner, but you need to go in and finish them off.
Really? Are you sure?
Absolutely. You just need to close the deal. Go in, be tough, and let them know you're with me. They'll hand the deed right over.
Well, great. Here, I'll set you up for a discount. Thanks for the help.
I'll take it.
Oh, blue rose of Illium. Let your roots dig deep into the hot soil of T'Chanka. Let our scorching sun.
What do you want? Sorry, that damn Krogan's love poems are getting on my nerves.
The Krogan's reading those love poems to get your attention?
His name is Char. We're kind of dating, but, well, we're on a break. And he's trying to show me how sensitive he is by, well, wooing me. It's really bad.
Let our scorching sun.
So why are the two of you on a break?
He's serious. Serious, as in talking about kids. Char is a great guy to date, but for something permanent... Krogans live long lives. It's not like dating a human where you just stick it out for a century till they die. No offense. It made me wonder if he really likes me. Or if he just wants kids. He can't have them any other way, you know. Because of the genophage.
That sounds like a question you should ask him.
I did. I don't think he realized that our kids would always have been Asari. Non-Asari don't always get that we're not taking alien DNA, we're just using it to randomize some of the genetic information. Anyway, Char was quiet for a long time. Then he said that he'd love our girls no matter what color they were.
It doesn't seem common for Asari to date Krogan. What brought you two together?
He's a fun guy, really smart. Especially for a Krogan. And he's got a good job as a transport technician. It's fun to join a mercenary guild or dance at bars for a few centuries, but eventually you hit the matron stage, you know? Then you get your back tattoo removed, let your scalp go back to its natural blue, and settle down with someone dependable.
You need to talk to your boyfriend. He's just gonna keep shouting poetry until you do.
I know, but it's tough. I like him a lot. Hell, I love him. But I don't know if he's permanent bond material.
Look at him. He's obviously crazy about you.
Is he? I mean, what if he just wants to have kids? Am I just his baby-making machine? He said I wasn't, but...
If he said that, then you either trust him so you have nothing to worry about, or you don't, and you've already decided.
I guess I hadn't thought about it like that. And I do trust him, if he said it. I'm going to talk to him. Here. I've given you a discount at the terminal. Thanks for the help.
What about a fish? She loves the garden. We could add a pond. What about you? Going to try and make it as a commando?
Why not? Every Asari has biotics.
I'm telling you, relax. Vax will never notice a few missing pieces. No, I can't get in. Because it's a crime scene. It's all locked down. Eclipse mercs, some Justicar, I don't know.
For example, you know that new drug, the one that causes permanent neural scarring?
That's horrible. I'm on a call.
You can sell something that dangerous with just a contract and a waiver?
These are the
No, I haven't had any luck yet. She insists it was legal. I don't know. I'm going to call in a favor and have a friend examine the contract.
Nothing to declare? Move along.
Corporate security. What a life. Regular breaks, regular paycheck. Still not worth it. Killing on salary's too easy. I have to work for every job I get. Makes me really look at the job. Makes me care who I'm hunting. Otherwise, it's just another name on a piece of paper.
Shepard. I don't suppose you'd remember me. I'm Shiala. We met on Pharos during the Geth attack. Saren had given me to the Thorian creature as a slave, and you killed it. And saved me. I promised to help Zeus Hope recover. I'm actually here on Illium for just that purpose.
Is it Exogeni pushing colonists around again, or did the Thorians somehow survive our fight?
No. Exogeni has been very supportive of Zeus Hope. They actually seem to want to help us survive, and the Thorian is dead. Though, after all you went through to kill it, I understand your concern. I fear that after our adventure on Pharos, my purpose on Illium will seem mundane by comparison.
How's Zeus Hope doing?
We've done a lot of rebuilding. We even salvaged some useful material from the Geth ship you destroyed. The Exogeni researchers got called back to their headquarters, however, along with what was left of the Thorian.
Is there something I can do to help?
I'd appreciate it. I've reached the limits of my diplomatic abilities, and I'd prefer not to start trouble. Some of the colonists had health problems as a result of the Thorian control. We hired a colonial survey group to do some medical scans. But The medical contract apparently allows the company to perform invasive procedures without our consent. That's why I'm here.
Wait a minute, Shiala. You were only green when the Thorian made you a clone. The real you was blue, like normal Asari.
Those health problems, I said, were related to the Thorian control. This is mine. A few months after the Thorian died, my skin pigment changed. My biotic abilities are unstable as well. I'm also having vivid dreams about my time with the Thorian. It is disconcerting.
Tell me more about the contract you signed for these scans.
Barrier Frontiers was interested in our problem. They offered to perform medical scans and deliver treatment for next to nothing. I should have known it was too good to be true, but we were desperate. In the fine print, we apparently agreed to let them perform invasive follow-up procedures if they deem it valuable. Which they have.
Can they actually force these procedures on you?
No. But they can declare us in breach of contract. Which means we're responsible for the full price we would have paid normally. Zoo's Hope just got back on its feet. There's no way we can afford that, Shepard.
What kind of health problems did the colonists have?
Headaches or muscle spasms, similar to what they experienced while under Thorian control. Sometimes the colonists near another former Thorian victim shared sensations like heat or pain. It has to be a result of trace amounts of the Thorian's parasitic spores. You can see why we'd want it studied and cured.
I'll talk to the survey group.
I appreciate it, Shepard. The Barrier Frontier's representative knows about the issue.
I saw your conversation, human. You're here to complain about the medical contracts those colonists from Faro signed. I suggest you leave. Your life is short enough. Do not waste what time you have bothering me.
What's your problem with humans?
Not just humans, it's all of you. The Salarians and Turians are no better. The galaxy would be a better place if nobody but the Asari had ever dragged themselves out of the primordial muck.
Perhaps we could work out different tests. Something that will work for both sides.
If the colonists were not willing to abide by the terms of the contract, they should not have signed it. The onus is not upon me to accommodate them.
So you'd be this harsh in your contract terms if these were Asari colonists?
If they were Asari, they'd be dealing with problems unleashed by another race. Asari like my bondmate, who died when the Geth rebelled against the Quarians. Or my daughters, who died during the Geth attack on the Citadel. One worked in the embassy, the other was a greeter for the consort. I'm not speaking in hypotheticals, human. The aliens will never be my allies. The best they can do is give me useful medical data.
Why was your bond made on the Quarian homeworld?
Studying the Quarians. Not their technology, but their music. She loved all their art. Said they had old souls. I think that's where my daughters got it from. Both of them love talking with people, exploring new cultures.
They sound like wonderful people. The galaxy is lesser for their loss.
Yes, it is.
Do you think they'd want you to do this?
I didn't... Sending an amended contract. No more tests, no fees. There's enough grief in this galaxy. I don't need to add to it.
D,
Did you get the star charts?
Yeah. I had to deal with Arrhenia, though. I feel like I need a shower.
What do you expect? She's a pureblood. They're all like that.
You did it. I just got the revised contracts. Thank you, Shepard. You've saved Zeus' hope again. I don't think I could have... Is it always like this? Yesterday's problems lingering in some new form. Isn't anything ever just fixed?
You've got the new contracts. It's fixed for now.
Thank you for what you've done here, Shepard. I'll keep doing what I can. Maybe sometime when I'm not organizing the colony and you're not doing whatever you do.
You know Irinya won't even talk to the non-Asari customers. It's like she's turned pure blood into her religion or something.
Nothing to declare? Move along.
I don't know. That still sounds like an awful thing to legalize.
All the dangers are right there on the package. It's legally required.